In this video, we're going to go over how to link or reference another Google Sheets spreadsheet using import range function and some extra tools. And we're going to do it in a way that doesn't break. And to demonstrate what I'm talking about, let's first of all just start with this. We have this spreadsheet called First Sheet. And here, let me just rename this tab. It's called Sheet 1. I'm going to double click and call this one Main Data. Now, in this tab, I'm going to add some numbers here. So let's just call it Amount and add a few numbers here. And we'll use those numbers in a formula on a different sheet. So first of all, let's just change this to currency. So now let's try to reference to these numbers on this second sheet. And to do that, we're gonna have to use import range function. So I'm gonna go someplace here and do equals import range. And the first argument here is gonna be spreadsheet URL. So I'll go to the second sheet, copy this URL on top, this one, go back to this, and here in quotes, I'm gonna paste that spreadsheet URL. So that's the first argument, comma. And the second argument here is range as a string. And that also has to be in string format, meaning in quotes. So I'm gonna go double quotes. And for now, I'm gonna close parentheses. And within those quotations, we're gonna reference the range. And the range, if I go back to this, this is D2 through D4. And the tab is called main data. So I'm gonna go here and do main data, which is the name of the other tab, exclamation, and then D2 through D4, like so. Now at this point, if I hit enter, first I'm gonna get this ref error initially because we need to give permissions to access that first sheet. And to do so, we simply just click on this ref, and this pops up, so we're gonna click allow access. And now we have access to that range and you can see we get our totals. Now, I'm gonna double click here and there is a couple of things I wanna go over here. Number one, this URL doesn't have to be the entire URL for the other file. You can simply just do the ID of the spreadsheet and the ID would be this part right here, see this after this D forward slash going after this forward slash edit. So basically I can get rid of this part and I can get rid of this part and just keep this URL of the spreadsheet. And if I enter, this will still work just fine. And this way it's gonna be shorter formula. Now this main data is the name of this tab here. This is D2, D4, the range. Now you can also put this in single quotes, main data. So if you're familiar with referencing, you are required to do the single quotations if you have spaces or other characters here. But here, you don't really have to do the single quotes. If I do them, it's still gonna work just fine. But I can also get away without actually doing those single quotations, just the name of the sheet, followed by exclamation sign, and then the range. If you want, you can also do open references like this, like D2D. And the idea of that would be if you later basically just add more data to this second spreadsheet, when I go back to this, it will automatically basically pull that data. Now, at this point, you can then use this inside of other functions. For example, sum. So I can go here and put sum around this, close parentheses, hit enter, and that will just basically sum those numbers and give you the total using the data that's located on this. And of course, you can see now the total is 254. If I add another, let's say 70 here, we go back and take a look, it will update to 324. So that's great. Now, the downside of all of this is, if I actually go back to that first sheet and add a column someplace here, and then we go back and take a look at what happens, you can see my total is zero, because in this formulas, when you do this range, you basically provide this as a string. So essentially, this is just hard-coded D2D from this main data worksheet. And because I add a new column, now this is no longer accurate because this is going to move to E, but our formula is going to have no reference or idea that this actually happened. And it's going to stop working as soon as you add or delete a column because things have moved. Another thing that could happen if I just delete that column, you can see it's going to work again because it's D column. If I go back here, you can see it works. But then the other thing that could happen, if you change the name of this, let's say I call this main data 2. Once again, if I go back to that second sheet and take a look, you can see this is going to be broken now as a reference because there is no main data anymore. So it's not going to know to update it. It's still going to look for that main data and it doesn't exist. And we're going to get this error. So I'm going to go back and delete this. So that brings us to, how can we avoid this problem? Now you can see this still giving me the reference, and sometimes it just doesn't update very fast. So I should be able to just refresh this whole thing, and you can see it's fine now. Now that brings me to, what can we do so this doesn't happen? And to avoid this problem that I'm facing right now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to that first sheet, and I'm going to use a named range. So what I'll do, I'll select this list and go to data menu and named ranges. And here it's going to ask for a name for this range. So I'm going to give this some sort of name. I'm going to call this sales data, no spaces or special characters here. And then this is the range we're pointing to. I'm going to press done. And this is a named range. If you're not familiar with named ranges, you should probably watch a separate video just about named ranges to learn about them. But right now I have this sales data named range. And if you already had one, this is the screen you're gonna get first. So you're gonna have to click add a range and then do the same thing. I'm gonna cancel this because I just did. So now I have this sales data named range. So because of that, I should be able to go back to this second sheet and open this and then change this to sales data, like this. And notice I'm not doing the name of the sheet, exclamation sign or anything, just the name of that range. And now if I'd enter, I should be getting the same thing, but here's the interesting part. Now if I go to that first sheet, and add, let's close this, add a column over here, and then go back and take a look, you'll see this still works just fine because even though it moved, the name is the same. And because of the way named ranges work, when I add a new column, this first spreadsheet will automatically update the reference to this data. And this way, even if I change this name of the sheet to, let's say, main data 2 or whatever, again, it doesn't really matter because we never even use the name at all here. So this still works. It doesn't fall apart. It doesn't break down. And we're fine, even though I'm going to add a column here or maybe even add a row on top here or whatever, this is still going to work just fine. Now, of course, if you want to continuously just keep adding to that list, then you need to probably define the name a little differently. So you would go here, named ranges, and this is that range. So I'm going to click on this and we can update this. And one way is to, well, the thing here is that if I just try to drop the end of the reference like this, hit done, what it's going to do is, see, it's automatically going to go to line 1001. It doesn't allow you to actually use open references inside of your named ranges. But what I could do is do something like this. Just use the whole column F, hit OK, and that is fine. So now I'm basically pointing, I'm going to delete this first line, I'm pointing to this entire column F from top down. And with a setup like this, well, it's going to ignore amount because sum function ignores any text. And as a result, what's going to happen, see, if I look here, this is my 324. Now, if I add another 76 here, it's still a part of that F column. So if I go back and take a look here, see, this 400 works fine. And once again, because it's a named range, I should be able to delete columns, add columns, whatever. And as I do that, if I go back and take a look, this still works just fine, no problem. And that's how you reference to a different spreadsheet in Google Sheets in a way that doesn't break, and your links to other spreadsheets still work just fine, even when you start adding, deleting columns and changing names of sheets. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.